Hi guys, welcome to this new video on Flaskan. In this video, we are going to see something about render templates and bootstrap integration with your Flask application. So you can see here that from the last video where we left, we have a simple application built here which has two pages, that is the home page and the about page, and I will show you the application. So this was my application on the about page, and when I go to the home page, so you can see this was the index page that we built. Now what if you want to add some more styles, like paragraph tag, or you can add ordered list, unordered list, and different HTML tags to make your web page attractive. So for that, what you can do is that you can add them here, but it won't be a good idea, because you know that HTML pages are very large, and if you write that same thing inside this two single brackets, so this will be a very untidy kind of development stuff. So for that, what Flask provides us an option. So Flask provides us with an module called as render templates, which will by default search for templates HTML files in a folder, that is this templates folder that we create, that I have just created here inside my main project directory. So for importing render templates, you can just directly import that in your Flask application. So I will write render templates. And once the render templates has been imported, so what you need to do is that you can create your own HTML pages in this templates folder. So I have created a new file, that is index.html. And what I will do here is that I will just write HTML and press tab here. So Sublime will automatically complete it for me, and in the body part I will just add a header tag, and inside the header tag I will write this. So this is done. So once you have written such a thing, I will also create one more file for the about page. So now I have created two main HTML pages, that was my index page and my about page. And now instead of returning this quotes written inside this header tag, so what I will do, we will return the render template directly. And inside this render template, we can directly pass the index.html. So by default, Flask is going to look for this index.html in the templates folder. But if you have this folder on some other path, so you need to specify the path here. And for the about page, we will also return this, write the same thing. So let's save the document and see whether that our application is still working or not. So I saved it. And we need to restart the development server, and our server has now been started. So I copy this IP address and paste it here. So you can see that our application is still working fine, and this was our about page. So this is one important application of render template. So you can create a number of HTML pages in this templates folder and use the render template module to import them in your project. Other thing that I wanted to show you in this video is about Bootstrap integration with your application. So what Bootstrap is? Bootstrap is an open source framework from Twitter that provides the user interface components to clean and create attractive web pages that are compatible to all modern browsers. So what Bootstrap provides us an option is that it provides us with an extension for Flask. And if you wish to install that extension for your Flask application so that you can use Bootstrap in your Flask application, so you need to write a command in your command prompt. So we'll come out of this session, and inside our virtual environment, we will install Bootstrap. So for that, we'll write pip install Flask Bootstrap and press enter. So you can see that Bootstrap is already installed in my system. If it is not installed in your project, so it will automatically get installed in your virtual environment. So once the bootstrap has been installed in your application, so now what we'll do is that now we'll use the bootstrap to actually make and apply to our web pages directly, so that we don't need to put more effort in designing the web pages and all, and bootstrap can manage that on their own. So for importing bootstrap in your application, we will simply write from Flask bootstrap. After importing the bootstrap application, once you have instantiated your app using the Flask main class, so you need to put it and inside as an argument for the bootstrap library. So now we will go inside our main application and I will delete this thing. So I want to tell you that the web engine that Flask applications use to read this web pages or web templates is known as Jinja 2, and Jinja 2 has an property to extend bootstrap. So for extending bootstrap in your Flask application, you simply need to write this line that is extends . So this simple line will by default extend the bootstrap in your all the web HTML pages that you write this line. And after you have extended the bootstrap, you can simply open blocks. So the use of blocks in the web pages of Flask application is that if you are using blocks, so you can also write control statements over those blocks, so that you can conditionally show the content to the user. For example, if I have a web page like this about page, and if I am the user and I want to see the page, so you can give the condition for that inside this using a if and else block. So if you want to know about this if and all the conditional statements that Jinja 2 supports, so you can just simply browse it on the internet and you will find all the condition statements that are supported in this Jinja 2 engine. For the sake of this video, I will simply show you a content block that I will make here. So for building the content block, it is as follows, and now I will close the content block. So for closing the content block, again you have to write the same thing as end block. So this is the block, and inside this you can write anything. So for a simple web page, what I will do is that I will show the same thing. I will save this thing. We'll check whether our server is running. So it's not running. So we'll make our server run. And we'll go and check for our application. So you can see that our server is still running. And we get this same line that this is my web page home. But now if you try to inspect the source of this page, so you can see that by default bootstrap has been loaded inside this web page, and you can confirm this by looking at this line that bootstrap has been installed, that bootstrap library has been extended to your HTML web page, and your source has been shown inside this body. And by default it also supports the JavaScript files that are provided by bootstrap here, and also the CSS file that bootstraps provide. So what we'll do is that I will show you a simple so I have certain HTML code written here. So what we'll do is that we'll just copy this whole code here and put it inside our block here. And just save the application. So we will just save it all, and we again go inside and check server is running. So we close this thing. So you can see here that this is how you can create your own web pages using render templates and bootstrap integration with Flask, and you can create marvelous pages for your application in Flask. So I hope that I have shed enough light on render templates and how to use them in your bootstrap application, and also how you can extend the bootstrap in your Flask application to use it for your purpose. So if you still have any doubts regarding this video or any content in this video, you feel free to write in the comment section. If you like my work, please do hit the like, share and subscribe button. See you till the next video.